Hey Jayde!
Hey T!
What does your job as a BBC journalist entail?
I work on the digital team for BBC News. So my team makes the videos that appear on the BBC News website and the social media pages. So my job is to come in, see the stories that are doing really well and think about how we can do that digitally and how that story will be more accessible to those who view our content on the BBC News website and the social media pages. So it's going to be something completely different to what you would see on one of the other platforms like the 6 and 10.
Why did you decide to become involved in journalism?
I became involved in journalism because I needed a change in my life. So I decided to completely change my career. And I kind of said to myself, what would make me wake up in the morning and just be happy to go to work? Even if they didn't pay me at all, I would still be happy to do that. I thought, you know what? I really like talking to people. I like hearing people's stories. And I do have a passion for creating content.
When did you make a start in your career?
How I started my career was I was like, okay, I'm quite a big achiever and I can just rock up, have an interview and I'm gonna get in the BBC. But to my surprise, it didn't kind of work like that. So basically I had to go back to the drawing board and I had to look at different courses and things that would make me more suitable to be a journalist. Then I stumbled across the BBC Local Radio Apprenticeship Scheme and I thought, this is exactly what I need. It's something that's gonna give me experience and training on the job.
When did you make a start in your career?
I started my career at the BBC in 2014 at the age of 26. I left behind a career in education because I really needed a change in my life and I needed to do something that was gonna make me ultimately really happy. Not that education didn't, but at that point in my life, I needed a change.
What top 3 skills do you need to become a journalist?
The top 3 things you need to be a journalist, I would say, are good communication skills so that you can talk to people and find out their stories. Some of the best stories come just by talking to people organically. Secondly, I would say you need creative flair because it's all about putting people's stories across creatively in a way that people will find it really interesting. And thirdly, I would say you need strength and tenacity. This industry is a very competitive industry and sometimes it can take a lot out of you, because also sometimes you've got to remember some of the stories that you're hearing can be quite tragic stories, so you need to be as strong as possible and you know, you've just got to have that drive to just keep going forward.
Who helped you?
Who helped me? Oh my gosh, so many different people. So I hope I don't offend anyone by leaving anyone out. So firstly, I would have to say Julian Joyce and Gareth Roberts, because they were the people who gave me my first opportunity to work at the BBC. So I would have to say they helped me. Also along the way, I would say Sue Green, who kind of taught me everything that I need to know in terms of journalism, the academic side of it. Then I would also have to say Sunny and Shay, they're presenters on BBCWM, because their show was the first show I ever produced while I was still an apprentice. So they gave me that opportunity, which, you know, seems crazy now looking back. I would also have to say Irene Azari, Joe Aldred and Nikki Tapper. Irene Azari was the producer of Chatback, which is the programme that used to be presented by Joe Aldred and Nikki Tapper. Irene really took me under her wing and also taught me other things that I needed to know and how to be a better journalist. I would also then have to go on to Joe Aldred and Nikki Tapper, because I did then go on to produce their show, and you know, the things that I learned from them is invaluable. Also Adrian Goldberg, another person who really helped me, because I think with Adrian was the breakfast presenter. He is really hot off the press. His journalism is second to none. Pitching stories to him, you can't just pitch him anything. You've got to have it all together before you go to him with a pitch, because he's just like, what is this story? Why do I care? And that kind of has definitely shaped me in terms of the kind of stories that I tell and how I tell them. Also, another person who's been a really great help to me would be you, because obviously I started this journey with you, and you've been a constant source of help and support. Many others that I can't name, so there, those are the highlights. I hope I didn't offend anyone, but yeah. So, but you know, also I have to say God as well, because obviously I do have a relationship with God, and I know that He leads and directs me. So I know that all of those people that I mentioned have been put in my life by God. Anyway,
what's been one of your biggest learning curves during your career?
Biggest learning curve of my career would be that nothing is promised to me. And that, you know, I kind of, because I've always been quite an achiever in life, I've really kind of felt like I should get every job I apply for. One of the things that I've learnt is that actually other candidates are probably just as strong as me, so nothing is owed to me, really. That's probably been one of the biggest learning curves of my career.
What advice do you have for young women who aspire to get into media?
I would say just do it. Do you know what? If it's something that you want to do, be bold, be confident, and go for it. I would also say, when you get in, have a good network and a support system of friends that will help you, that will support you, and keep you grounded. I know that, you know, it's been something that's been really important to me, to have good people around me that I can talk to, that can help me and support me, because this is a very competitive industry, and you know, it's a massive corporation with lots of different people and lots of different policies and lots of different things going on, and sometimes those things can take you over. And so it's good to have a good support system of people around you that can help you, support you, and that you can lean on and depend on or cry on.
Thanks for joining me in today's Careers Corner, Jayde. It's been so nice to chat.
Thanks for having me, TC. Bye.